Hello, I'm Sherry Rote, registered dietitian at Western Wisconsin Health, and today I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about emotional and boredom eating. You know, for all of us right now, there's a lot more time at home, and this can bring on, you know, we're missing out on all of our plans we had, vacations we had, so that can bring on loneliness, sadness, frustration, worry. And for some of us, we're still working, or we're finding ourselves working at home and also homeschooling our children or doing daycare. There's more cooking, there's more cleaning, there's more worry about staying safe. You know, and this is scary times for us. We don't know about our 401ks right now. I know some of us, me in particular, are getting closer to retirement. And so it's a little bit scary for us for sure. Job insecurity, our health, what does our future even look like? So those are all things that sometimes can lead us to emotional or boredom eating. And I just wanted to talk about two different systems we have in our body right now. One is called the sympathetic, and that nervous system is really fight, flight, or freeze. And we feel those emotions pretty fast because they're kind of stored in the amygdala, kind of in the back of our head. So first we kind of process that emotion or that feeling, and then right away the amygdala is going to kick in. And what do we want to do with that? And then the other system that we have is called the parasympathetic system. And that's sometimes called the rest and digest. And that wants to soothe us and kind of get us back to normal. So what I'm going to tell you is that emotional eating really is a way that our body is actually trying to bring us back to a normal, because that's all our body really wants to do, is get us back to normal. And our body knows that when we digest food, we do it better when we are calm. So when we eat, the parasympathetic nervous system kicks in and our heart rate slows, our muscles relax, and our breathing actually even gets deeper. So we're better off actually after we've done some emotional eating than when we first started. So it's knowing that it's normal can help you feel a little bit better, but a couple things that we have to keep in mind when we're eating for hunger, you know, is much different than we're doing emotional eating, because if we're hungry, then our stomach is going to send a signal to our brain that we're full and we're going to stop eating. And that usually happens around 20 minutes. So for emotional eating, our body isn't recognizing that we're hungry. So we can do a lot of damage in that time. You know, so thinking about different scenarios about emotional eating, the first one might be that you come home and you decide right now, okay, I'm going to do a Zoom or a Facebook time. I'm going to connect with my friends. I'm going to maybe take a walk, get some fresh air, listen to some of your favorite music, do some reading or whatever it is that you like to do. And then maybe you eat a bowl of ice cream. Scenario two is where you're feeling stressed, you're constantly going out to the kitchen, you're grabbing ice cream, you're grabbing chips, you're grabbing cookies, you're grabbing whatever. That is when you're just relying on food to soothe you. And that's where we can get in trouble fast. So that sympathetic nervous response happens fast, like I said, and it takes a while for us to practice, but one thing that we can work on is trying to take a pause. So, and that pause can be as much as just like breathe in 1 second, breathe out 2 seconds. Kind of try to identify, you know, what is going on right now. Certainly trying to keep some of the bad foods out of the house can be beneficial. But then also maybe taking a look at your hunger cues. Maybe you find yourself walking out to the kitchen, you know, kind of doing that 1 to 5, 1 being very hungry, 5 being very full, trying to keep yourself in that 2 to 3 to 4 range, always kind of rotating in there before you start to eat, and then kind of taking a look at after you've ate. You know, I've seen some funny memes of people on Facebook putting notes inside the refrigerator to shut the door and get out of there because they're not hungry, they're bored. And you know, those aren't really bad cues. Maybe if you have a pantry that has your snacks in it, maybe put a sticker up there and say, let's just do the hunger cue analysis, or let's, you know, just think about where we're at right now. So before you eat, And after you eat, always thinking about those hunger cues. So journaling right now would be a great time to journal if you feel like you're struggling. Maybe think about what you ate, why you ate, and how you were feeling. Can you identify like what feelings are popping up that are causing that emotional eating?